Well, an actor who's rewritten the rules. Always a pleasure to speak to you. So after a rocking 2018, 2019 is looking no different.
Yeah, I hope so. I hope actually better. Opening is with Badla. You know how we say boni ho rahi hai meri. So I hope 8th March proves to be lucky for me, for the sake of Women's Day, for sake of everything possible. It should work out for a wonderful 2019.
And as a character in the movie space, the one thing that I'm willing to bet on is myself. That's actually you, right?
Yeah, actually I found that line so Naina Sethi / Tapsee Pannu. Not that I had an option, I have nothing else to bet on. There's no one else who I can bet on other than me and my decisions myself. So I have, and the same goes for Naina Sethi, and that is what was one thing common between me and Naina. I always try to find that one common thread with the character I play. Mm-hmm. And then build upon it. So this was the common thing, that she built everything from the scratch by herself, for herself. Same goes with my history. I had to do everything by myself, for myself. So I think that is what helped me understand Naina better, that line.
You know, someone said something very interesting for you. They said the reason that you take risks are because you have nothing to lose. Like, you are playing the
I only would have said that line about myself.
No, but this is someone outside. Recently I spoke to
really?
You. Yes.
I think that person just heard one of my interviews where I said this. I do say that. And people ask me, how do you do these roles? How do you choose it? Or, you know, it's risky to see you making these choices. Don't you get scared that, you know, you might come across as too aggressive in your choices, or, you know, people might just get scared or intimidated to take you. I'm like, what do I have to lose? From where I started, it's only upwards from there. You cannot take me further down. As I said, I don't have a surname to live up to. I don't have set of rules for my conduct anywhere. It's only set by myself. And whatever I achieve, the credit or the backlash is to me, myself, nobody else. So I guess that gives me that freedom, independence, or, you know, that confidence.
But you set up some very high standards, and, you know, maintaining that so consistently also can become quite a bit of...
But, you know, it doesn't feel that much because, as I said, I've built it myself. It's not a facade that I've created. I've honestly chosen the roles I honestly believed in, tried to portray them honestly, and I'm quite honest off the camera as well. So I think that is what gives me the confidence that it's mine. So I only have set it. It's not like someone else has given it to me and every time I have to struggle to live up to that standard. Mm. Then it's difficult. Now, I only have built it means I've naturally had that thing of taking it this high for my own self. I want to match it and I like to match it.
And as a Twitter handle says now, all real flesh, blood, bones and a spine.
And a spine.
And, you know, maintaining a spine in the industry that you are in and also the times that we are living in is very difficult. So how does Tapsee Pannu manage to be so erect?
See, that's what you just asked me and I'm going to answer it the same way. I honestly don't have anything to lose because I don't have someone backing me up right now. Jiska support, if it goes away, I don't know what to do. So I'm not trying to please anyone in the industry. I can't even socialize with agendas. Mm. So that's why I have a very, you know, not such a big social group in the industry. I can talk a lot, you know that. So it's not like I have problems, issues talking to people or having communication issues, or I'm extremely extrovert. I can talk on a wrong call for a really long time.
Really?
I have done that as a kid. So it's not, the problem is not in communication. The problem is I have issues with socializing with an agenda. I can't be in a group or clan just because I know I'm going to benefit in work because of that. It's very weird. I can't look into myself in the mirror if I do all this. So I end up saying, okay, jinke saath kaam karungi, I know they'll repeat me. That much, you know, I can, at least I've been seeing that with my filmography till now. And that's because I honestly love my work and enjoy working with these people who I'm working. So they end up giving me another chance. But penetrating into a group with an agenda, it's something that I can't do, which costs me a lot of films, sure. Which now I have made peace with. It will be that my path will be a longer one, a more risky one, a more struggled path, but it will be mine. Nobody can come and say, ye iski wajah se, ya uski wajah se, ye sirf meri wajah se. So at least I can make peace with that fact.
And working as your people, wanting to work with you again, Mr. Bachchan, he's doing a very good job of defending you.
Yeah, imagine who has anything to fear when it's Amitabh Bachchan defending you every time. Who has it? And when people like, you know, when Veer Amitabh Bachchan or Akshay Kumar working with me for the third time and Bachchan sir for the second time. So who has anything to fear?
But you know, jail, as you said, is really working well for you. The jail has rocked.
I've been saying that. I was like, whenever I've been to jail, it has worked in my favor. Who thought that would become a lucky charm for a character?
Exactly. And
I think next time onwards, I'm going to tell my director and writer that, can you please just suddenly, like, just put me in jail? Like in Mulk, I was not inside the jail, but I visited the jail. So I'm like, just put me somewhere around the jail. Anywhere.
But jail ki salakhe, as I said, Bollywood ke competition ki salakhe to aapne tod di hain. But Badla, Sujoy Ghosh, he's a master storyteller when it comes to thrillers.
Yeah.
So what was it about this particular film?
The series of events was kind of like little jumbled up in this one. When this film came to me, nobody was a part of it apart from Suneet Kheterpal, who had the rights of this film. He showed me the film and he asked me to do the girl's character of the original film, which is a character who gets murdered. So when I saw the film, I said, it's brilliant script, but I want to do the guy's character. So, are you okay swapping this? Because then only it is exciting for me to do the role. Because some people are okay, you know, being part of a great film and having a slightly insignificant role. But I am not okay with that. I am okay with small screen space, but it should be extremely significant. So, I asked him if he's okay swapping the gender of that character. And he agreed. So, I was lucky, happy, privileged that this happened. And post this, I think immediately after I said yes and I was locked, I called up Sujoy. I asked him that, you know, have you read the script? Because he was pitched the script as well to direct. And he said, yeah, I've read it, but you know, I'm not able to wrap my head around it. I don't know what I'll do with it. It's already brilliantly done. I don't know what to do. I was like, it's your kind of a film. Female protagonist, strong thriller, till the end you're hooked. He's like, yeah, but I'm not sure, what can I do with it? And his full bhav he had. And then 3-4 months later, I get to know Mr. Bachchan is a part of it and so is Sujoy. So I'm giving him grief since then till now, that when I called him and asked you to be a part of it, then you didn't agree. Now that Mr. Bachchan is a part of it, now you are happily a part of it. But yes, no one could have directed it better. No one could have played that part with Mr. Bachchan did better. I think it has perfectly fallen in place. 2 years it took us to finally get this film. From the time I said yes to the film to finally how we managed to put things together and now it's out. But it was so worth it.
And also as Naina Sethi is your character, and also you wrote that a strong woman is who built her foundation with the bricks that have been thrown at her. I want to know which is that one brick that did it for you. That, you know, you have that in the cartoons, you have that toying moment that changed it all.
That was not one, there were multiple. If you ask me one right now, I'll tell you one of them, which was quite hurtful. I was managed by a different agency, not the one that I'm managed by right now. And I remember Rashmi Badur was done and I was going to do my next film soon. And I had said that I don't stay in Mumbai, so help me at least meet director so I can, you know, at least network in a way to talk and, you know, meet them and see what I can do next. And they, after making me wait for months and months with no result, turned back and said, nobody wants to meet you. Ouch. Nobody is interested. Nobody is showing interest in even meeting you. So I was like, such a well-known agency and you seem to be very well connected. You couldn't even get me a meeting. Forget about, I'm not asking you to get me a film. Get me a meeting. So they just refused on my face that nobody is responding to your name. That kind of really hit me hard, that I decided to take everything in my own hand. I said, now I'm going to stop trusting people with my career decisions or helping me in any way. From that day till today, I have a wonderful team now who works with me. But I somehow realized that it's only you and only you who should take control of your career. There'll be people who can help you, who can support you, and that you need to have a brilliant team to help you. But your career decisions and your big steps will always be your own. And mine have been my own from there onwards till now.
And also, as I was, you know, observing in your films, the movies revolve around you. Your male leads, the heroes that we used to talk about, are the ones who are just supporting the female protagonist. Is it a conscientious decision, or they're just coming your way?
Mostly are coming my way. I have tried really hard to do other films as well. Like I did Surma, where I'm not the hero. I'm the typical heroine in the film. And I remember the first question that I got asked when I came out with that film's trailer was like, why did you do this film? You are not the protagonist, or you know, the central character of the film. I'm like, you don't ask this question to other hundreds of girls who do these roles. I'm just trying to mix and match. It's okay to be heroine sometimes. Every time I can't be taking the center stage, I won't be insignificant in the scheme of things. I can guarantee you that you'll still remember me when you walk out of the theater. But it's okay to not to take center stage sometimes, you know. So, but I don't think people are ready to see me doing that. Nor are the writers and filmmakers. Few days back, a writer comes up to me to pitch a script, and I'm like, okay, so what genre is it? You know, is it a love story? It's a girl-boy story? Or he's like, Majal Meri? Of course, it's a female protagonist. I'm like, are you serious? I'm like, I agree, I do that, I can do that, but I can do that as well. Now it's
now you've like been boxed as the female protagonist.
Yeah, which, you know, it's not that bad, honestly, as far as I'm getting different genres to portray, and characters are all different from each other. It's okay. But it should not in any way, this should transpire into the fact that I am not okay doing a role which is slightly lower than the hero. Though having said that, I always bring this out, and that's one thing that hurts me, or not hurts me, like at least it bothers me a little bit in the industry, that when we have central protagonist as a man, any other A-lister is okay to do a part which is, female A-lister is okay to do a part which is slightly lesser than the protagonist part. It never happens the other way around.
True.
Which is something that I really wish and hope changes one day. Because look at all our leading ladies, such brilliant actresses. Today, I think we have an amazing bunch of actresses in the industry. All of them are so good. And you look at the films that when they do, when they are central characters, and look at the films that they do when they are playing a smaller part. Such difference in the casting.
True.
Yeah, so it's very evident. And I wish someday a leading man answers why this happens, and you know, what's
but
wrong?
It's changing. May your tribe grow. It's changing. You girls are redefining.
We are trying to fight it out, you know, in our own way. We are trying to break it. It is yet to be broken. We still need to see a film in which there was a female protagonist. The man wasn't probably at par, but still significant. And there was an A-lister next to an A-lister doing that role. I will be so happy. Even if it's not my film, I will still be celebrating that day.
And you know, you had said if my movies like Man Marziyan, Mulk and Pink had not achieved that golden mark, that 100 crore, I would still be doing films to make money. But knowing you and having spoken to you, you would have still continued doing the kind of movies you want to.
Yeah.
Or do you think your career would have panned out differently? What if they had not made the golden, touched that golden mark that we...
What if not?
If not, hypothetically, suppose they have. Agar nahi hota, toh kya hota?
It's not, none of them have made 100 crores. A film like Judhwa 2 did. So it doesn't change my choice of films. I still do those films. Because I have somewhere hope that the audience is changing. And they are giving me hope by appreciating the work I'm doing and noticing it. We have kind of built kind of an image of Bollywood films. How the girls are in the film. How the boys are. What humor. What kind of masala formula. We have done that for years. Now to change it can't happen in like overnight. No? So it will take some time. You can't give up. So as far as you are getting appreciated for making an effort, and slowly you are seeing changes being made, it's okay. But I don't think it achieved the kind of golden mark that, you know, where I'll be like celebrating saying, ho gaya. Hua nahi hai abhi. And I'm hoping hoga. And thank God, abhi itni jaldi nahi hua. Nahi toh shayad I wouldn't have been able to push myself further. So it's okay. Next year again, I'll push myself. I'm not giving up on doing that. Because my films are not artsy films. They are not offbeat films. Yes, they are unconventional films.
Agree.
Yeah, but they are not the films. I don't watch artsy films. I can't watch films. Most of the times, I am not the person who can watch European cinema because they have a different taste in films and I don't identify with it. So I will not do those kind of films. So my films are commercial. You'll enjoy for 2 hours. They'll not be the regular masala films, but they'll hook you for 2 hours. That I can guarantee.
And after this, you've got Mangalyaan playing a scientist.
Mission Mangal, yes, yeah. I have that. Scientist, that's a big ticket film with an amazing ensemble cast. For me, one reason, there are two equally important reasons to do that film. One was the fact that it is a real story that we all are very proud of. Second was the ensemble cast. People sometimes probably, I mean, in fact, I was told by the director itself that he was like, when I asked him, I said, why am I the last or second last one you approached in the entire ensemble? He was like, because I never thought you'll say yes to this film. Because it was such a big ensemble that probably you, an actor who's used to doing the protagonist all the time, might just have a little second thoughts about being a part of this big group. You know, I said, that is my biggest fun, to enjoy sharing screen space with these actors. How many times do you get the opportunity to do that? To share screen space with such brilliant actors together. For me, it was an experience more than, you know, having achieved that film. Ki matlab is film se mera career upar ho jayega. That was not the agenda to do this film. It was just to enjoy a company of these actors together in one frame, how brilliant it's going to look. So that was my driving force. I'll do other films which will get me into that track of protagonist or, you know, the central donor. But some films like this you should do for the fun of it.
And when you're playing sharpshooter roles in
Oh God, that's the most difficult role of my career. People ask me about it right now. I'm very happy to see the curiosity in people about that role and film, Saan Ki Aankh. But I don't know what I'm going to do in that film or how I'm going to play that role. I've only shot for that film for 9 days before I came down for promotions. But it's the most difficult role of my career. I have
which
no
you're going
idea.
To ace it, and we are just looking forward to it.
That's the pressure now, which I'm happy with, but it's so nerve-wracking every day to get up, and because nothing matches with those characters and Tapsi. Like, I can't really see anything common. I don't know what to build upon. So it's very, very challenging.
Chalo, now on to something light. We did some most Google questions. What does Tapsi mean?
Tapaswini. It means Tapaswini, the one who meditates.
And how did Tapsi enter Bollywood?
Arre yaar, this though is very easy. You can search anywhere, you'll know. Via South. Because I was modeling, but studying, got a chance to act in films, did not want to. So just thought, maybe just for time pass sake, let's try a few South films. I'll learn something new. I tried, it worked. So I thought maybe God had better plans. And then after 2-3 years of taking it seriously in South, I got an opportunity in Bollywood. So tried that. Everything has been very, like, one opportunity at a time. As I said, whatever the bricks are thrown at you, make a foundation out of it. And that's what I made a career out of it.
And it's an awesome foundation. And the other Google question was, how does one propose to Tapsi?
I would love to know that. I would love to know that, because unlike the image that that people tell me I have, which is like they get really scared, pata nahi marna de wapas. I keep telling them, I only hit in movies for the sake of the role and character. I've never slapped a person in real life.
I've seen my whole picture, you've been like,
yeah, I mean, jab se maine bottle todi hai, tab se main todi rahi hun. Even before that, for that matter, in Baby. I've just been like at it, I feel. But then that's okay. But I really don't know how to propose. What is the perfect way to propose to be? I would want to like try different ways and see which one is better.
So whoever is Googling those, you've got your answer. And the biggest badla, now this is just a quick rapid fire, the biggest badla you've ever taken in life?
With a guy in school who left me for board exams.
He left you for board exams?
Yeah, he said, I need to concentrate on board exams.
Abhi tum dekh rahe ho. Regret it. And the one advice you live by?
I live by?
Yeah.
That live, don't survive.
Cardio weights?
Playing a sport.
Give up sweets or delete your Instagram account?
Give up sweets. I am not a sweets. I don't have a sweet tooth.
Well, we can actually see that. One thing you miss about Delhi?
Food.
And badla mein dialogue hai, badla lena har bar sahi nahi hota, magar maaf karna bar bar bhi nahi sahi hota. Do you agree with that? Forgive and forget, or
no? I can forgive, but I don't forget.
So those who ever have wronged her, she hasn't forgotten. So anyways, all the very best to you.
Thank you.
Two light questions. You've acted with both the Bachchan. Bachchan Senior, Bachchan Junior. Who's your favorite?
Of course, Senior.
Okay, Bachchan Junior. And favorite co-star, Abhishek Varun or Vicky Kaushal?
Abhishek Varun or Vicky Kaushal? I have to choose from three only, then I'll choose Vicky because he's a very dear friend.
And is Tapsee as cool as she looks in interviews?
I speak the same way off camera also. I think that is pretty much validated in all the interviews I've given. So yeah, because I am how I am in interviews. I'm not the same person in front of the camera in movies, but in interviews I am how I am off camera.
And what song describes your current state of mind?
Aaj main upar aasman neeche. That is describes most of the times my state of mind.
Since it's releasing on Women's Day, one advice you want to give to women? A wish for women on Women's Day.
I think a lot of debate happens on the fact that should Women's Day be celebrated, not celebrated, all every day is Women's Day and blah, blah, blah. I just say one thing. Till the time we achieve that equality, I think we do need this day. Only for the fact that this day, let's decide something which is in our control that we can do that takes us a step closer towards equality. So from me, this is my attempt to do a film like Badla, which has a role at par with the male protagonist, which I feel is, you know, kind of change that we're seeing in Bollywood today. This is from my side. Let's hope you give me a return gift of going into the theater and watching it and loving me. And I hope you have your decisions made as well.
Your feminine role model?
I think I'm pretty impressed with Indira Nooyi, if people ask me. But other than that, in movie world, I don't have one person who I trace actually a lot, yeah.
And your feminine superpower?
That I'm a female. That's the biggest superpower. Multitasking is the blessing God has given us.
Thank you so much. And since you're speaking of good times, your idea for good times?
Good times, my idea for good times. Just the time that you spend for yourself, for your own happiness, when you live, when you don't survive, is good time.
Thank you so much and more power to you.
Thank you. Thank you.